So I had a call with this guy who is trying to buy a business for the last 2 years, right? He's trying, he's going out there, he's talking to business owners. So he feels like he know how to find those businesses. He don't really focused on a specific sector, but he kind of like all over the place right now. I have so much energy, but based on what I saw, he's just not focused on that one path that can lead him to success, which I see with many people who want to get into this space. They have a lot of energy. They're very ADD, ADHD. They're like, they want to be involved in many things at the same time. And there's nothing wrong about this in this space of buying businesses, because you can talk to many business owners at the same time and it's exciting and it's always the next deal. So I was having a conversation with him and he told me, look, Moran, I'm trying to buy a business for the last 3 years, right? I'm trying, but it looks like I'm always getting into this deal, but nothing close. I'm just not sure what to do. Or sometimes I'm about to close, but then I'm like thinking there's a better deal. So I'm just leaving that deal and going to the next shiny object. And I suggested him, I think he have a great mindset, great attitude. He's committed to the process. So I invited him to our mentorship program and he was like, you know what? I'm not sure if wasting or spending a few thousand dollars right now into your mentorship is the right thing for me, because I believe that I can do it on my own eventually. I feel like I have the energy, I have the knowledge already from all of your free videos, which I do really. My free videos give you a lot of really in-depth information. I can tell you based on experience, some of the free info that you get from my videos will be more information that you get in programs out there that you pay $10,000, $10,000 for at least. But I told him, look, if information was the answer, everyone out there would be rich already. Everyone out there would own some kind of a company like Apple or Amazon already. So information isn't the answer. And if you think that spending a few thousand dollars on potentially buying a million-dollar business is expensive, I don't think you look at life the right way. If you asked my client, John, who bought three businesses in less than a year, if spending a few thousand dollars on mentorship is worth it or not, I think he would say that he would pay $100,000 at least for such a mentorship. Because here's the thing, what you need to understand, when you own the business, you then look at money that you put into mentorship as an investment. Before you get those results, obviously you look at it as an expense, as something that you're like, why did I even do that? And when I talked to him, I told him, look, how do you know that the perfect deal isn't there for you and you're just not sure about what's missing? What if you just had the perfect deal and you wouldn't know exactly what to do? Or what if you find an okay deal and you would make a mistake in terms of financials or legals and you made the wrong offer, or you made like mistakes with the legals? Like, the way that I look at mentorship and investing in something like this is not about the money that I put into mentorship. It's about the money that I'm losing and not making by not doing the things. So for example, look at one of, put them in perspective, right? I have John, who bought three multi-million dollar businesses in less than a year. And I have this guy I talked to. And again, he's an amazing person. He got the great mindset, great attitude. He got all the information in the world that he probably needs. Like, if he's joining my mentorship, maybe he'll get a little bit more nuances and small details, understanding of the process and details of what's working right now in the space of deal making. So it's maybe another 20, 30% in terms of information. But the way you should look at it is what he's missing. So he's missing the accountability, the support, the second set of eyes of someone to look at his deals and help him in terms of not making mistakes. And what I'm suggesting in him is that it's not about the money that you will invest in the program, it's about the money that you lose for not investing in the program. So he's already looking for deals for 2 years. So he's basically, let's assume that he bought just one business in 1 year, which is more than doable. And that's why we try to get it to a point where you're in the program, there's no way that you'll not make at least one deal if you're committed and you're not giving up. So for 2 years, he's trying on his own. And basically, let's say that each year he bought a multi-million dollar business, just one. Let's say he bought this year $2 million business. The second year, he bought a $4 million a year business, which is very, very doable, just one deal a year, right? Being very conservative. So basically, he now lost $6 million in revenues in businesses that he could now own and already make money from. But because he's saving money on mentorship, he's not making that amount. And it's basically every day that goes by and he's not getting the right support. I don't care if it's for me, for anyone else, from anyone else. I just don't know any other program who's giving that much support and accountability and care about their clients as much as me and my team do. And I say it with 100% confidence and certainty because I've been in all of them and I know what's out there and I know how much people care about you for real. And what I try to explain to him is that, look, how do you know that the perfect deal won't be there when you are not prepared? How do you know that you didn't already miss the perfect deal? Or how do you know that if you close the deal, it won't be bad for you? So you're paying every day that goes by and you're not putting yourself into a mentorship program like that. You're spending millions of dollars into the university of not knowing, into the one day, someday space. How many deals do you want to miss out before you're making that decision? You can spend years of your life doing the wrong things and then finding yourself with the wrong business. Like I know many people out there who spend a lot of their own money buying the wrong business and buying shitty businesses that are losing the money, and then they need to inject more capital just to continue to trade that business. So how long do you want to continue with that? How long do you want to continue staying where you at in your average life while knowing other people out there are netting 100, 200, 300,000 a month from doing those deals? And I'm not even talking about the exits that they can make, or about a few million dollars in cash in your bank account that they can put from owning those businesses and then deciding to sell them. So every day that goes by, you're losing all that money. So it's not about the money that you're wasting or not investing in the program, it's about your time. And the time is the most important thing in this world. So in my opinion, it's much more expensive to stay without any results. It's much more expensive to stay poor, to stay where you're at. This is the most expensive stuff. Not investing a few thousand dollars in mentorship that's giving you everything, A to Z, with the nuances, with the details, with showing you exactly what's working right now, with the support, with the accountability, with the team that's helping you. That's what is really expensive, not having that access to all those things. And heck, I mean, the average family in the US, UK, they're spending thousands of dollars a year on Starbucks. So all we're doing right now is redirecting some of the money to now give you freedom, to give you financial freedom in terms of your time, in terms of your money, in terms of your emotional account. Because if you're not successful in terms of money, if you're always uncertain about how much time you have or how much money you have, you can't really be fulfilled and happy. So I see this space of helping in terms of business buying, not just in terms of financial freedom, but emotional freedom. Because when you have money and time, trust me, it's much easier to be happy. And when you see that full picture, that's how people out there can go out there and buy one, two, three businesses. I have people who bought 30 plus businesses. I've been involved in many businesses. I'm involved right now with WeKix, with lots of tech companies. We're doing roll-ups in the UK, US. I mean, it's possible. Making a few million dollars from different deals, having lifestyle, having the time, because you can. That's what's cool in the space of buying businesses. You can do a sprint, do a deal, and then chill back, step back, and then do another sprint, do another deal, make some money from that, step back. A few million dollars here, step back. A few million dollars here, step back. It's an amazing lifestyle, and I really want you guys to experience that. And I don't want you to regret and get to a point where in 5-10 years from now, you didn't buy any business, and you're thinking with yourself, why I didn't spend that money, why I didn't invest in a mentorship like that. So if you want to learn more about that, on how working with us can help you buy at least one business in the next year, then see the link somewhere below and schedule a call with me and my team and let's get to work.